Hi everyone, we're on the top 15 of the Geraldine Esposa segment. Costume, everyone. This is something new, everyone. So the top 15 will be competing in the Albanian national costume. Miss Canada Glow. This is Miss Canada Globe, everyone.
Hello, welcome home.
Walking out of town. So each of the top 15 is now modeling the Albanian national costume designed by an Albanian designer. The next is sorry guys. This is Miss Italy. Miss Montenegro's coming up. Miss Montenegro. Miss Kosovo's coming up. This is Miss Kosovo, everyone. Next is Miss Ukraine coming up. So this is very different this year again, everyone. Instead of the white gowns, the top 15 is modeling Albanian national dress. Miss Ukraine, everybody, this is Miss Ukraine. Miss Philippines is coming up, everyone. Oh, actually not Miss Philippines yet, everyone, sorry. Miss Czech Republic is coming. Miss Czech Republic. Miss Siberia. Siberia, everyone. Miss Ghana is coming up. So this is Miss Ghana. Miss Albania is coming up, Miss Shibria. Miss Albania, everyone. The next is Miss Sweden. North Macedonia. And Miss Brazil. So Miss Brazil is coming up, everyone. Miss New Zealand is coming up. Philippines is coming up, everyone. Miss Philippines. They had to put the two Filipinas together. Miss Philippines is coming up, everyone. So Miss Philippines is coming up, everyone. Miss Philippines.
I can't find my
Kosovo, everyone, and that is the special Albanian costume for the top 15, which they will announce the top 5. I just want to show Miss Canada Globe. And Miss Philippines right there. Hi everyone, so there you go, the top 15 in a very new segment. Just to let everybody know, it's instead of the white gown, they did the national costume or national dress of Albania, and they will about to announce the top 5. The top 5 finalists will compete in a question and answer portion, as far as I know, so wishing everyone good luck. So, everyone is excited. Let's hope for the best for Canada, for Philippines, for Macedonia, for all of the girls that were put on the top 15. They did an amazing job. So, and thank you so much to Kim Maestrado again for doing my hair and my makeup. Thank you to Luis Pangilinan for my beautiful outfit that you're seeing. And also, thank you, Luis Pangilinan. Oh, Kim Belen also for providing the power bank, because I'm nearly dying out of battery. So. So we're just waiting for the top 5, everybody. And I'm here again with Peter. Sorry, I'm already losing my voice.
Helping a little bit out with the voice.
Huh? Thank you.
Mia is sitting here since hours now, since already before the show, and she's commenting and moderating everything, all emotions of the girls. So she's doing a stunning job, but it's not finished now.
Yeah.
We still have to wait for the winners. Stay tuned.
Thank you so much, Peter. What did you think of the top 5, top 15?
Beautiful. I saw your girl is in.
Canada got in,
Philippines got in.
Yes, Philippines got in.
New Zealand got in, so.
New Zealand is not my girl, but I'm supporting her.
Yeah, but she is.
I'm supporting original. All the girls.
Yeah, for yes. Sure, but she's original Filipina, no?
Yes, so. Yes. So.
You're more than happy today, no?
I am. I can't wait. My throat hurts. I'm just waiting for the final 5. The top 5, everyone.
We are all waiting for the final 5 and for sure for the winner.
Yes, yes, yes.
Stay tuned. I have to go back to my space.
Thank
Sorry.
You. Thank you so much.
See you.
So we're just waiting for the final 5, everyone. I'm kind of like nervous, so please everyone, crossing our fingers. So, it's coming up everyone. I'm nervous. Net, live your one, sealing through home net, internet, we And just to let everybody know, with, as you know, Miss Globe has a height requirement, right? But Philippines being a petite, that's a great achievement for her coming into the top 15. And thanks to all her supporters who voted for her, because that was the way for her to be in the top 15. And now she's in the semifinals, and we're really hoping that she would make top 5. So, and again, I'd like to explain to everybody the fact that she was appointed and was only given a few days to prepare herself to come to Albania and represent Philippines is an amazing achievement. The top 5 is based on the overall performance of the girls throughout the whole week. Thank you. We're about to start, everyone.
Sorry.
And again, thank you so much for tuning in. We are about to come back. Top 5.
The top 5 finalists. But first, I want to thank very much the mayor of Tirana, our big supporter. Thank you so much, Tirana. Okay. I think the jury is voting, and I'm waiting for the top 5 finalists. And we go.
Okay, they're about to announce the top 5, everyone. Top 5. Got in on the top 5. Congratulations, Miss Siberia.
Miss Siberia, please.
Miss Brazil got into the top, second top 5.
Is in the top 5 finalists.
Okay.
We continue with the next one. Miss Philippines.
Yes, Miss Philippines got into the top 5. Third finalist. Congratulations, Miss Philippines. So Miss Philippines is
the
there.
Miss Ghana.
Miss Ghana, fourth finalist. So there's Miss Ghana. So Philippines has secured in the top 5 position. So, here are your top 5, Kosovo, Philippines, Ghana, Brazil, sorry, and Siberia. So congratulations. Now it's a top 5.
Moment would you like to relive? Miss Awesome. Thank you, everyone. First of all, every moment of the past made me who I am today, and it's a productive who I am today, and the success that I have today, but the moment that I'm at the moment states to have my mom moment.
Now it's Miss Philippines.
To go back in time, I would want to relive the moment when everybody is on its normal phase and everybody was just having a normal life. What I mean is, I wish we would realize that we should have taken the things for granted, just like how things are right now. And this would be a simple reminder that we should always appreciate what we have right now and learn the lesson of the past. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Philippines.
That's a good answer, Miss Philippines.
Miss Ghana.
Miss Ghana.
If I was to go back to a point in time, it would be before coronavirus. I feel like coronavirus has ruined a lot of lives and taken away a lot of businesses. So I'd like to go back to a time where we don't have to wear face masks. We don't have to think about where we're going. Family members all around the world. There's a lot of people who haven't seen family members in weeks or months even, and I would just like to send my gratitude out to them. So I would like to go back to the time before coronavirus.
Miss Brazil.
Miss Brazil. Hi everyone. I'm so happy. Thank you very much. Miss Brazil doesn't speak English or Portuguese.
Miss Colombia will be translating the question for her.
Miss Colombia. And I have to say something to her. For Miss Colombia. Was the final of the Miss Talent competition, and we had many girls on stage and many translators. Like Miss Colombia was translated Miss Brazil, Miss Kosovo, Miss Turkey. And Miss Kazakhstan, Miss Siberia, and I think Miss Spain, Miss Italy. So we are many. Once again, Miss Colombia, thank you. No, she has the microphone, so she can answer in Portuguese, and Colombia will translate in English. You can talk in Portuguese. Portuguese.
The question has to be translated. She needs to translate. The question.
Oh, the question, yes, you're right. If you would go back in the past, which moment you would really once again?
Si estuvieras, o sea, si pudieras viajar al pasado nuevamente, ¿cuál momento revivirías nuevamente? Si pudieras vivir en el pasado, ¿cuál momento revivirías?
Ok, thank you. Yes, it's importante. Então, todos os momentos foram únicos para mim. Foi um concurso super ótimo. Tive várias experiências com garotas incríveis de vários países. Fiquei apaixonada pela Albânia. Estou muito feliz por estar aqui. E muito obrigada a todos.
Ok. So you said all the moments are very important for she. And in this contest, she is so happy. So she really lives this moment and all the moments she can be.
Thank you. Thank you, Miss Brazil. Thank you, Miss Colombia. And you have to come up with Miss Siberia, so I need Miss Kazakhstan.
So Miss Kazakhstan will be doing a translation for Miss Siberia.
Thank you, Miss Kazakhstan. Once again, the translator. Please translate the question to Miss Siberia. Moment would you like to relive?
своих родителей, сказала им спасибо за то, что они меня любят, за то, что они меня родили и за то, что они у меня есть. Спасибо.
If I return to my best time, it's exactly my childhood times, because I want to tell to my family thank you. Thank you for burning, thank you for being happy, and it's definitely my best memories if I come back to
thank you, Miss Siberia, thank you, Miss Kazakhstan.
So I just want to let everybody know that the final answer is not the basis for the crowning. This is basically for the whole overall performance throughout the week. Okay?
So the voting of the jury.
Please remember that. So I'm just letting everybody know it's not based on the final answer, but the overall performance.
Thank you. Invite on stage to crown the fourth runner-up and third runner-up, Mr. Armand Peza, the administrator of Geraldina Scusa.
So the fourth runner-up and third runner-ups are being awarded now. So the fourth runner-up.
Miss Globe 2020 is Miss Philippines.
So Miss Philippines is fourth runner-up. Congratulations. Congratulations, Miss Philippines, fourth runner-up of the Miss Globe 2020. That's a great achievement, everyone. Please. Miss Brazil is third runner-up. Miss Ghana is second runner-up. Congratulations, Miss Ghana. Tell you something, everyone. Philippines is happy because she knows that Miss Globe has a height requirement. And due to the fact that she is petite, she knows, because for the fact that her height was not explained properly. So please, the fact that she made to the top five is a great achievement. And she was supposed, they were supposed to give the proper requirements, and the height itself was the main factor. She's not 5'6", which is the minimum height requirement of Miss Globe. She's 5'3". So please remember that. What I'm talking about, like, people are not very sports. Again, I've explained it. Rowie did not explain that she's 5'3". Minimum height requirement is 5'6". The fact that she's top five and got fourth runner up is an achievement. So please. Later on after this show. And again, congratulations to Miss Philippines for being fourth runner-up. Despite of her of the height requirement, she was able to still be on the fourth runner-up position. And congratulations also to Miss Canada Globe for being one of the top 15. And again, thank you so much for watching. Just good vibes, everyone. Miss Positive.